Hello and welcome. My name is Rubies and this is CAT, also known as CAT. Today I'm going to feature an FPS game called Shoot Mania, which is made by Ubisoft and Nadio. Nadio you might know from Trackmania games, which share the title and client to some extent. So, Shoot Mania, as you can see from the video, is a first-person shooter game focused on multiplayer. They have quite an ambitious attempt to make this game a next big esport FPS game, and actually there has been a tournament already while back in Alpha, and well, you can find match videos from YouTube if you just search with Shoot Mania tournament. So basically, the tournament mode in this game is something that I find quite interesting, and it was actually quite funny to watch also. So it is a 3v3 mode where 3 persons are defending outpost, which can be captured, and only one man is trying to attack it. After each round, the turn changes. The other team that was attacking is now defending, and vice versa. So you might think 1v3 is very weird, and there is no chance for that one person to actually do anything. But there is little niche in this thing. The one person gets a laser gun, which kills enemy with one shot. The person also gets 3 armor points. The defenders get rocket launchers, which take 1 armor point from hit, and they can only shoot 3 rockets before they have to wait for the downtime. So even though it might seem unbalanced, it is actually quite balanced and interesting to watch how one person can killed three guys alone. So basically the idea is said to eliminate the attacker or defending team, defend the outpost for 1 minute, or capture the outpost. So it's quite simple, but there is quite a lot of depth, even though it might sound simple and very plain. So this mode I'm currently playing is called Royal, which is survival free-for-all, where the aim is to be the last man standing, as you might imagine from the free-for-all. You can activate this pole in the middle of the map, which starts a storm that's coming closer and closer to the center of the map, eventually creating a small space where the rest of the players alive have to fight for their lives. Everyone caught in the storm will die instantly. As you might notice, there is no weapons visible, there is only this aim or sight, whatever you may want to call it, and it might seem lazy at first when you look at it, but in the end it doesn't actually matter at all. And since it's made for more professional, if you might say, they tend to turn off the weapon models anyway to gain more visibility. So it's something that doesn't have any effect. And so yeah, I wouldn't put that much of negative point for the game with that. It doesn't actually matter. So you can see the UI is very simple. You have in the middle bottom you have this health bars, which in this mode is 2 hits and you're dead, except from the storm, which is instant. You see your ammo. It varies in different weapons. On this weapon I have 4 ammunitions, which I can shoot quite rapidly before I have to wait a bit to gain more, but as you can see it's gaining rapidly all the time, so it's not something that's holding you back that much unless you're just trying to spray your enemy down. And also you get this sprint bar here, which gives you momentary boost, which also helps you jump higher and longer, which is quite nice in my opinion. And actually there is at least one map that forces you to use it in order to survive the map. You start from small platforms and you have to jump over a electric river which instantly kills you if you land on it. As you might notice, the game is localized. I have it on Finnish and I'm quite convinced it's over 20 languages at least what I looked, so most of the common languages at least will be covered. There might be even more than 20, I'm not sure as I haven't actually counted that, but there are plenty, so that should be enough for you to know. And actually the difficulty of hitting your enemies is in my opinion quite high. It's not something that you have in Call of Duty or anything, that it actually requires quite a lot of prediction of where your enemy will go, and you have to take a little bit of advantage. One quite new game that's doing the same thing is Stripes, which also has this thing with most of the weapons that you have to shoot in advance to actually hit the target. This is also the case with most arena-based FPS games that like Quake and Unreal Tournament and so on. So, apart from the Last Man Standing and Elite mode, there is also Melee mode, which, well, is self-explanatory. You get to hit with your weapons and with your melee attacks. So it's free-for-all mode also, but only melee attacks. Battle mode, which is team-based pole capture mode, time attack, and Joust, which is one versus one match with limit ammunition. I haven't actually tried all these gameplay modes at myself. I played this Royal, which is something that I actually enjoy quite a lot. And even though I sucked the first three rounds very bad, I still enjoyed it. And well, in my opinion, in this video, I'm well better than most of them, so it's improvement anyway. I actually hit a few targets and so on. So as said, it's currently in beta stage. They are sending invitations which are lasting 7 days and from activation. That is currently the only way to gain access to beta. They have already announced the cost which grants you the access, but it's not still on sale. The cost is $19.99 if I recall correctly, but as said, you can't yet buy your way into the game, but you can always sign up for the beta and hope for the best. That's what I did and gain access. So I would say that it looks nice, which is quite obvious. The lack of weapon models is something that I don't actually care that much about. You might wonder it at start, but you get used to it very fast. And I think it's quite ambitious in a way that they are trying to make this a complete esport game, and well, at least they have quite a nice start since there aren't that many FPS games that are taking esport scene at the moment. Of course there is Call of Duty 4 and well, Counter-Strike to some extent, but they are not that big games anymore really. So I really hope this game can get some esports status, as I like to watch the Elite mode, and maybe you also enjoy it if you go and take a look and at some of the videos in YouTube. So because of the what they are trying to get with this game, I would say that this is an ambitious attempt and also a cool game to play. It keeps you interested, and even one shot at the enemy gives you some sort of pleasure and sense of accomplishment, since it's very hard to hit and it only requires two, so it doesn't get frustrating. It just feels quite rewarding and nice. So my name is Ruby Ace, this game is Shoot Mania. Please leave a comment below, hit like button or dislike, and tell me why you choose 801, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content from all kind of games on alpha and beta stage. Maybe some let's play if I've, well, from Alice Madness Returns, and maybe something else. And if you have a great idea what I could do, you could also tell that in comments. But for now, thank you for watching, and see you another time. Goodbye.